The sensory pleasures are not to be negated. This is the whole aspect of Devi Shakti. She has created this manifested world. Everything is her. Whatever you can experience as a form is nothing but Devi's manifestation, half Shiva's manifestation. She is the manifestation. As I said, feminine is the manifestation of the form. She is the movement. So if this phone is created, through a certain movement, this phone is created. There's an aspect of feminine goddess in this. She is the mother of this creation too. Yeah. So everything that you experience through your senses is her. Because the Shiva aspect, the masculine aspect, is absolute stillness, non-doing. So whatever you experience through your sensory field, the idea behind this was that your senses must be too sharp, that when you take a sip of a cup of tea, your senses are so sharp, your senses know how to delve deep into this experience of tea. And when you are experiencing that depth of tea-ness, you are experiencing the divinity. Each sense or each sensory object, the object of your sense pleasure, is a doorway to that unity, is a doorway to that completion. It is no wonder why we run after these sensory pleasures. Taste, touch, smell, see, hear. Humanity is running after these pleasures. It is not a fluke. Because each sensory pleasure, as I said in the earlier part, gives you a glimpse of that, gives you a glimpse of completeness, but for a short time. Just for that moment when you're sipping that cup of tea, and that too will only happen if you do not allow your mind to wander while you're having that cup of tea. If while having that cup of tea you allow your mind to wander, then you've missed that. Then there's no glimpse, not even the completeness. So ideally, how should you conduct your senses, your life with the senses? A. Whenever you experience anything through the senses, know that this manifestation is her, is Shakti, is Mother Goddess. Even that cup of tea, even that mountain, that beauty that you're seeing. And when you start to know that, even conceptually, a certain reverence will start to come in your heart. Now this is important linkages, Atul and everybody else, please note it. When you start to experience any object, even I'm saying object, and you're deriving a sensory pleasure out of that object, and you start to know, even conceptually, that this too is her, this manifestation, this object which is manifested, is also manifested just because of her energy. A certain gratitude will start to come. A certain reverence for even that object, Atul, will start to come. Now look at the beauty. Whenever reverence comes for anything, for any thing, any object, any person, whenever the reverence comes, even a small object, Atul, starts to become divine. From a thing, it starts to become a being. Look at this movement. From a thing, just as a thing, non-sentient, suddenly that object starts to become a being for you. Infused with life, infused with richness of life. It is no more an object in your experience. Prana pratishtha, in a way, you've infused it with divine life. So from it's a movement from thing to being. And this transition will only happen if there's a reverence for that. And that reverence will only happen if you will start to even conceptually know or experience or feel Mother Goddess, Divinity, Devi Shakti in all manifestations, in all forms. You remember in India, especially when we were children, we were small, we used to go to school. And you know, books like a book. So I have a book. Yeah, any book, even the school books, we were not supposed to throw them disrespectfully. Any book, even newspaper, we were not allowed to, you know, just throw a newspaper disrespectfully, because we were told that this book, whatever is written here, is form of divine. Saraswati. Saraswati is a goddess of knowledge, wisdom. So every book we treated as the manifestation of Saraswati. You remember Atul in our childhood? That's how our entire generation was. We grew with that thought process. Anything that can offer you wisdom in a written form, any book, was considered as a manifestation of Ma Saraswati. And it was disrespectful. So we were supposed to be in reverence for the book. By mistake, if your foot touches the book, you remember, you know, we used to do this. Put it on the forehead as a token of respect. Yeah? But if you logically look at it, what is this? A sheet of paper, some ink on it, chemical ink, not even organic, some colors which might not even be good. There's nothing in this, no? We could just throw it. No, this is the culture we build. Yeah? So with that reverence, books suddenly started becoming being for you. They were no more a thing for you. They became alive. We started even praying to the books. Like Gita. Just a couple of pages printed with a certain ink. You know, but for it's a reverence. Yeah? So yeah. So that's how reverence changes the quality. And this is how you must experience the world with your senses. Yes, there is an issue. The issue is we get entangled, as I said in the opening sentence. We get entangled with this experience and we want to repeat the experience. And the whole philosophy of Ardha Narishwar goes out of our thinking. We don't pay attention to that. We just get entangled with the experience. Then we start to repeat the experience. Then we become addicted to the experience. So an experience which could have become the doorway to the divine becomes an addiction. Can you see it? Think about this. Yeah.